If you visit different websites, whether it is YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, almost everywhere you will find this feature called infinite scrolling. In this video, I'm gonna show you how can you build that infinite scrolling effect with vanilla JavaScript. I'm not gonna give you just one method, I'll be giving you two methods with the help of which you can add this feature to your website. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsar with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. Before jumping into the video, if you want to go along with me, this is the code that I have taken from the last week's video. In that video, we have talked about how can you build the responsive masonry image gallery without using CSS grid, flexbox, and media queries. And as a bonus class, at the end of that video, I have shown you that how can you generate multiple random images dynamically with vanilla JavaScript. As you can see, we have very little line of CSS, HTML, and JavaScript code. So I did use all codes internally, okay? I didn't create a separate file for the separate code. So now with the help of live server extension, let's look at the result in our default browser. As you can see, multiple random images, they are generated with the help of this code. We did generate that multiple random images dynamically. Now for the HTML part, just below the debut class name card, let's create image element, and I'm giving source images slash loading dot gif. So we are using the gif file. As you can see, in the same folder, I do have folder name images, and inside that folder, you can find out that loading.gif file. But if you want to create same loading animation by using HTML and CSS, then definitely I would create a separate video on that topic, but let me know in the comment box. But for now, let's use this GIF image as loading animation, and for that image, let's keep the class loading. Now let's check out this in our browser. You can see huge loading animation. So now let's give some style for this GIF image. Inside the style tag for the class loading, let's give the width of 6 rem. For the height, I'm giving 5 rem. Okay, this is the exact size that I want. Now let's take that loading GIF image horizontally center of your browser. So for that, if I give for the div with class name app, if I give text align to center, now you can see that loading GIF image is horizontally at the center of your browser. Now in order to create that infinite scrolling effect, when you scroll and reach at the end of your browser, at the time you need to show your loading GIF image, otherwise we have to hide that. So in order to do that, for the window, let's give the event scroll. So I'm writing window.onScroll. So now when you are scrolling your window, at the time I'm using arrow function. So now if you write const curly bracket scroll top client height and scroll height is equal to document dot document element. Now it's like a trick. So with the help of this code, you can now access these three properties from that document element object easily. So why do we need these three properties? Suppose this is your browser, these top and bottom sections, these sections are the sections which are not currently visible in your browser, and all these three sections which are visible and invisible sections, these all sections that represents the scroll height, and that visible section of your browser, that is what we call client height. Now when you scroll, along with that, our scroll top value will increase. So how will you know that when you scroll down and you reach at the end of your browser? So now in order to calculate that, if we add the value of scroll top and client height, if we combine these two value, and if that combined value is equal to or greater than scroll height, then we'll come to know that we did reach at the end of our browser. So now let's give the condition. I'm giving if scroll top plus client height, if that is greater or equal to scroll height, then, so let me show you in the console what kind of value that we are storing in that scroll top. In the browser, if I scroll down and when you reach at the bottom of the browser, okay, that console.log code didn't execute, okay. So the reason is that I have to give some offset value. I'm giving client height plus 1. Once again, if I scroll down and when you reach at the end of your browser, did you see that? We did get that scroll height value. So the reason for giving that offset value, it's all because you can see the scroll value, we are getting some extra decimal digits. So due to that, we are unable to get fixed value of that scroll top. So with the help of that little bit of offset value, I did try to execute that code just before you reach at the end of your browser. it's time to show and hide that loading if image. So in order to do that, first of all, for this image element, I want to give the extra CSS property. So now for the class loading, when you give show class, at the time, let's give the opacity of 1, otherwise I'll give the opacity of 0. That means initially loading if image, that will be hidden, but as soon as when you give class show for that image, at the time that image will be visible. Let's look at the browser. As you can see, now that image won't be visible. We need to give that show class dynamically with the help of JavaScript code. For that, first of all, let's select this image element. As you can see, I have already given their class loading. So let's duplicate the same code. So I did use their comma in order to prevent constant keyword multiple times. Let's change that variable name to loading, and also let's give class loading. So with the help of this document.query selector, I'm trying to select that image element with class loading. Now I can write loading.classList.add. So we are adding show class for that image element with class name loading. As you can see in the CSS code, whenever you are adding that class show for the loading class, at the time we have given the opacity of 1. But what if you scroll down and if you didn't reach at the bottom of your browser? So for that condition, let's give else condition. So at the time, let's duplicate the same code, and now instead of adding that show class, let's remove the show class from that image element with loading class. Okay, once again in the browser, if I scroll down, as you can see, when you reach at the bottom of your browser, we are getting that loading if image. But if you scroll a little bit up, did you see that loading image is hidden? Now it's time to generate random multiple images dynamically as soon as you reach at the bottom of your browser. Now I need to modify some lines of code. For the number of images, instead of that 25, let's give to 10, and let's call for loop and take it inside that render images functions. Close that for loop. Okay, this code is not necessary. Let's remove that. Now we need to invoke that render images function. So now when you scroll and if you reach at the bottom of your window or browser, at the time, let's call that render images function. So once again in the browser, you can see when you reach at the bottom of your browser, at the time you are getting that loading animation, and our images, they are dynamically generated. So this was all about the first method. Now it's time to look at the second method. For the second method, I want to take the help of intersection observer API. So first of all, let's create constant variable observer, and I'm assigning new intersection observer. So now with the help of this intersection observer, we need to observe the targeted element. Okay, so the targeted element that you want to observe, that is the loading animation. So you can write observer.observe. So we are observing that loading if image. We can pass their loading. So now when you observe that loading animation, certain actions need to be taken. So that intersection observer, for the first parameter, it will take the callback. That callback will take list of entries. So you can give any name as you like. I'm giving entries, and for the callback, I'm using arrow function. Now let's console.log that entries. In the browser, you can see in your console, we are getting array, and inside that array, we are getting their intersection observer entry. You can see there are different properties, something like target, and the property that we're interested in is intersecting. So currently it's false. So with the help of that is intersecting property, we'll come to know that whether the our targeted element, in our case loading animation, whether that animation is visible to our screen or not. As soon as that animation is visible to our screen, that is intersecting property will return the true boolean value. Now we need to iterate all those list of entries. So for that, I'm using for each loop. For the array, you can give their entries. Now this previous method, this is now not necessary. Let's comment out this code. Now you can give the condition. So I'm giving if element dot is intersecting. I think now instead of that element, it's better to give loader. So as soon as that loading animation that is visible to our screen, at that time we will dynamically generate multiple random images. So for that, we can call that render images function. And also let's copy this code and let's paste it there. Now instead of adding that show class, we'll use toggle method. Now with the help of that toggle method, we will add and remove that show class dynamically, and that will be depending upon this code. Okay, so let's keep that loader dot is intersecting. As I have already shown you, that is intersecting property will return the true and false boolean value. So in the browser you can see, but there is some problem. As soon as that loading animation is visible, we are generating that multiple random images. Now what I want to do is that when that loading animation is 100% visible in our screen at the time. We want to generate the random multiple images. So that intersection observer for the second parameter, it will take options. So we can give their object within the curly bracket. We can give their property something called threshold. So this property will take the value range from 0 to 1. So 0 means that is the 0%, and 1 represents the 100%. So if I give threshold to 1, now in the browser you can see when you're that loading animation is 100% visible at the time only. We are generating multiple dynamic images. You can also give like 0.5, that means the 50%, but I want to change back to 1. So this was the second method. And talking about these methods, if you are just targeting the single element, that first method, I would say that would be better. But if you are targeting for the multiple images or the multiple elements at the time, second method is the best. Or if you are trying to create lazy image loading at the time, I would prefer that second method. So once again in our browser, if you scroll down, as soon as you reach at the bottom of your browser, you can see that loading animation reappears, and along with that, multiple random images are dynamically generated. Now everything is working perfectly. So this is what you call infinite scrolling. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already yet, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn. So keep learning.